Hey tipsters, I wanted to make a quick tutorial on getting set up with a virtual phone provider called OpenPhone. I really like OpenPhone for a number of reasons. For one, their app allows people who live outside the United States to have a state-based phone number. Their mobile and computer apps are extremely intuitive and simple to use, and their setup is probably the easiest I've ever seen. They also allow a user to set up an auto text response on missed calls, voicemails, or whenever someone calls in general. Beyond that, they also integrate with Zapier, which means I can have OpenPhone pretty much do anything I want it to when it comes to automation. As per usual, I always want to try and include the negatives as well as the positive, but honestly, it was pretty hard to find something negative to say. If I were to highlight anything, their customer service is only email-based, so sometimes they take a little longer to respond than if they had phone support, but with how simple their setup is, I honestly don't know how big of a deal this is. I guess the other thing to be aware of is that they don't include a virtual fax line, but I've never found that to be a big deal because I use Traveling Mailbox as my business mailing address, and they have a virtual fax line included within their service. If you don't use Traveling Mailbox, you can always use your local UPS store on the rare occasion that you actually need to receive or send something by fax. So far, OpenPhone is probably my favorite virtual phone system, and I've used quite a few in my time as a real estate investor, from CallRail, RingCentral, Freedom Voice, and others. With that, let me go ahead and log in, and I'll show you exactly how to get set up with OpenPhone. Now, for most land investors, our primary purpose for a virtual phone provider is to route all calls to go directly to voicemail. To do that with OpenPhone, it's so easy, you literally just have to click a button or two. Let me show you. The very first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna go to your phone number under inboxes. You're gonna go ahead and click these three dots and you're gonna select settings. Make sure that the phone numbers tab is selected underneath where it says workspace settings, and then you're gonna scroll down to where it shows voicemail. And you're gonna upload your custom voicemail. There's a couple different options for you. You could upload a file, you could record a voicemail right here on your computer, or they have this nifty text-to-speech option where you could type in your voicemail, and then they'll have a computer voice actually read what you type. For the sake of example today, I'm gonna simply just upload a file that I have set up for my land business. So we're gonna use the New Land Voicemail 2022. Now that that has finished uploading, we're gonna go ahead and test it out, make sure that it's working. Hey there, this is Jaren with iBuyLand.org. Perfect. And now, we're just gonna go up here where it shows the username. Obviously, this is a dummy account for the sake of this video, but we're gonna go ahead and click on it, and then we're gonna select this Do Not Disturb button. Then we're gonna go ahead and select Until Further Notice, and now, whenever you call in, it goes straight to voicemail. It's literally that simple. Now, the negative thing about doing it this way is that when someone calls in, they won't hear much ringing. A lot of the times when you call in under this setup, you don't even hear a ring at all. It just simply goes straight to voicemail. I don't know if this is really that big of a deal, but I know, speaking for myself, when I switched to OpenPhone, I wanted to set up my system exactly how I've always had it. So I wanted there to be a ring for 10 seconds before going to voicemail. In order to set that up within OpenPhone, at the time this video is being recorded anyway, you're gonna have to be on a premium account, whereas the first option I showed you can be done on the cheaper standard option. In order to get some ringing before it goes to voicemail, on a premium account, this is exactly what you do. Go ahead and keep Do Not Disturb on, still here underneath the inboxes underneath this settings section with phone numbers highlighted. We're gonna scroll down to where it says phone menu. Then we're gonna click on this and we're gonna set a greeting message. Now, you're gonna wanna upload a 5 to 10 second audio file that has the standard ring sound we commonly hear when we make a phone call. For your convenience, I've included a link to one in the description box below. So we're gonna go ahead and click on this. We're gonna select upload a file, and then where it says ring MP3, and by the way, OpenPhone always needs audio files to be MP3. We're gonna then select open. Then underneath where it says menu options, we're gonna delete number 2 here because we don't need it. We're gonna make sure that the key is set to 1, and then we are going to set it to go directly to voicemail. Then underneath option 3 here, if no option is selected, we also want that to go directly to voicemail. So we're gonna go ahead and hit save. And now when we call in, this is what we hear. And there we have it. Now, when it comes to adding text message auto replies, all you have to do from here is scroll down to this section called auto replies. For me, because I have everything go to voicemail, I avoid setting up incoming message auto reply. I only have it set up for on missed calls and on voicemail. As far as I can tell, under this setup where we have everything go directly to voicemail, you need to have text replies set up for both the quote unquote during business hours section and during after hours section. In full transparency, OpenPhone may only require putting the text under the during business hours section, but I haven't properly tested this at odd hours like 12 a.m. or 2 a.m. So just to play it safe, I have it set up for both business hours and after hours on my account. I do know that if you only set up auto text under after hours, it doesn't seem to work, at least at the times that I've tested it. And I'm very aware that this seems really weird because with office hours being disabled, I haven't declared what time blocks I should be able to send text messages. That's why, in case OpenPhone is somehow defaulting to certain business hours that I can't control or see, I'm simply setting it up for both and then not worrying about it. Now, why am I going through the process of showing you all this regarding auto text replies? Well, my goal here is to highlight just how easy OpenPhone is to get set up. As you can see, all it took was a few clicks, and now every single time someone calls in to leave a voicemail, I now have my phone system automatically send them a text, which is proven to have higher engagement and also helps capitalize on leads that for one reason or another don't end up leaving a message on the answering machine. This saves me a ton of time, energy, and effort because it's all automated and almost takes no time to set up. It's honestly pretty hard to beat. Let me go ahead and do one more test call with the text message auto reply in place, and then we'll wrap up today's video.
Hey there, this is Jerry with iBuyLand.org. With that, I look forward to us making a deal happen soon. Thank you so much.
And there you have it, my friends. I want to give a special shout out to my assistant, May, who helped me call in and leave a voicemail. So thank you, May. You're awesome. And as you can see, the text message went right out after she left the voicemail. Now, as we approach the end of today's video, there's one last thing I want us to go over. If we scroll down to this section called integrations here, I want us to briefly discuss this connect to your email button. Currently, I use a software called REI Pebble as kind of the command center of my land flipping business. And this email notification function is actually what they use to sync up with virtual phone providers like OpenPhone to automatically populate a new lead record each time a potential buyer or seller leaves a voicemail or sends a text message. The way that this works is that on the right subscription level, REI Pebble provides a user two different email addresses, one for seller leads and one for buyer leads, that are uniquely tied to that user's specific account. Within any third-party application, as long as that application happens to send out notification emails, and as long as that user lists that Pebble-generated email address as the preferred destination to receive notification emails, regardless of the platform, be it an online listing directory, the results of an intake form from a website, or a voicemail or text from a virtual phone provider like OpenPhone, with each notification email sent out, a new lead record will automatically generate within Pebble, which is pretty sweet because you don't need to use any kind of online automation tool like Zapier. OpenPhone can handle this level of automation 100% natively on its own. To give an example, let's take a look at my real OpenPhone account and not this test one that I created for today's video. You can see under integrations here that I have email notifications set to go to the seller inbox email provided by Pebble, as well as to my assistant's email at cashoffer@ibuyland.org. It's honestly that simple. And hey, if you're not using Pebble or some high-end lead tracking system, I still heavily encourage you to push all incoming activities from OpenPhone to a designated email address, because it's honestly a great way to keep things organized. And in fact, before using Pebble, that's exactly how I processed all my leads. I had a particular Gmail account, and all inbound notifications, whether it be a text message, voicemail, missed call, or what have you, was set up to automatically go to that specific email address. To wrap things up, I honestly don't know of an easier virtual phone setup, and I hope that this video serves you well. As always, for more tips, tricks, and real-world guidance on how to crush it as a real estate investor, come and join us over at REtipster.com.